This small town is home to the world's largest deposit of critical minerals that power the modern world. Satellite images reveal massive open pit mines where workers toil around the clock to produce essential components for all our electronic devices, from smartphones and electric cars to fighter jets. But there is an issue. This town is in China, which has near monopoly on these minerals, providing around 90% of the global supply. And now, in response to President Trump's tariffs, China has restricted the supply of these critical minerals to the United States. What will happen next? Can the world keep spinning when one nation holds the key to our technology and is not afraid to lock it away? Rare earths are somewhat of a misnomer. The name suggests the minerals are scarce, hidden treasures buried deep within the planet. But the truth is more complicated. The 17 metals with tongue-twisting names like neodymium, dysprosium, and yttrium aren't actually all that rare. In fact, some of them are more abundant than copper or lead. The real rarity lies in finding them in concentrated, mineable deposits. They're scattered across the globe in tiny amounts, but only a few places like the small Chinese town have them in quantities worth digging up. But even after discovering these deposits, the real hustle starts. Extracting and refining these elements is a dirty, complex, and costly process. And this is largely why China has maintained its dominance for so long. So while rare earths are not rare in existence, they're rare in accessibility, making them the ultimate prize in the modern tech race. China's got the world by the throat. They mine 240,000 tons a year, 70% of the planet's supply, and refine almost 90%. The current restrictions in response to Trump's tariffs aren't the first time China has weaponized rare earth minerals. It has done so before. In 2010, China cut off the supply to US ally Japan over a sea dispute. So what's everyone else doing about China's dominance over these critical minerals? The US is desperate. It's got one mine, right here, in the tiny state of Wyoming. But it's not enough. More than 70% of its rare earth still come from China.
You're in no position to dictate.
These rare earth minerals are also at the heart of recent tensions between the US and Ukraine, which has been discovered to have major rare earth deposits. Trump wants Ukraine to sign a deal allowing the United States to extract those resources in return for US military and humanitarian support for the embattled nation. Then there's Greenland, which Trump has threatened to take over. I was recently there to investigate this further. I just received this report from the Greenland government. It reveals one of the key reasons that Trump has his eyes set on this island. The report highlights that Greenland has a wealth of rare earth minerals that are critical to America's tech and defense sectors if it wants to keep a competitive edge in an increasingly technology-dependent world. At Greenland's Ministry of Mineral Resources, I got to see some of the island's most coveted minerals, and they looked absolutely beautiful.
I have almost everything.
This is Greenland's Deputy Minister of Mineral Resources. He insisted that we don't film his face because he doesn't want to be recognized when he travels around the world. Not everyone wants to be famous.
There is a list, both in the United States and EU, there's a list of critical minerals, for example. We have, in the United States, there's a list of 50 minerals that they think is very important for their industry and other stuff. We have 45 of them.
In other words, Greenland is essential for the future of America's technological innovation. No wonder why Trump is going crazy for this place. If you dig right here, you're likely to find rare earth minerals that are key to making all sorts of electronic devices, from electric cars and smartphones to wind turbines, from MRI machines to fighter jets. And ironically, the melting of Greenland's ice due to climate change is good news for those wanting Greenland's natural resources.
The main effect of climate change in relation to mineral exploration is that the seaway and the window where you can operate in the sea is more open. And now you also have a possibility to go to the top of Greenland and make exploration and exploitation up there.
I'm now standing in front of the recently opened United States consulate in Nuuk. That happened in 2020, shortly before the end of Trump's first term. The consulate marked America's first diplomatic presence in Greenland since 1953, when the US closed the consulate it had opened during World War II. We don't live during a world war now, but Trump's decision to reopen the consulate and Biden's decision to keep it signaled the growing significance of Greenland and a renewed US commitment to the region.
I think it's important to look at the dynamics of the world, and currently with China having such a large dominance on rare earth minerals and the refineries, and Europe and the US being very dependent on these for the green transition, for the production of cars, for many different things. And I think for some of the minerals, China has stocks of up to 2 years where they can just send that into the market. So they're dominating and they're controlling the pricing. And I believe that both Europe and the US, through the interest in Greenland and 13 or 14 other countries which they've signed up agreements with, have an interest in shifting the balance. And being more self-sufficient in this part of the world and reducing the dominance of, for instance, China on this.
Take a look at this newly constructed airport in Nuuk. It's actually at the heart of a significant Trump administration effort to block China from expanding its influence in the Arctic. In 2018, China offered to fund this airport and two others in Greenland, which is financially dependent on Denmark. As soon as news of the proposed deal broke, the Trump administration essentially said, "Not on our watch," pressing Denmark to scrap their intended agreement. Denmark ended up financing the $100 million project, and a year later, the Trump administration granted Greenland a $12 million aid package. It's uncertain whether that aid was directly tied to canceling the Chinese deal or not. Though it's hundreds of miles away from the Arctic, China calls itself a near Arctic nation, highlighting how critical the Arctic has become for global superpowers. Also, in his first term, the Trump administration signed an agreement with Greenland to explore its rich mineral deposits, including rare earth elements. But I was surprised to learn that US investment in this sector remains really low.
We have about 80 plus licenses that are currently handed out by the government, and about 50 of those are on Greenlandic hands, and the rest would be on foreign hands.
And do we know the foreign hands?
Yeah.
By country?
Yeah, we do.
Which country?
UK is the biggest, and we've got quite a few on Canadian hands as well. We only got one on US.
These rare earths are a huge deal for the US. It's throwing cash and wartime powers at it. The Trump administration is even eyeing Russia for deals. US allies in Europe have got scraps and dreams. 2 years ago, a major rare earth reserve was discovered in Sweden. With more than 1 million tons of rare earth oxides, it's the largest in Europe. Australia has an even bigger deposit, containing 5.7 million metric tons, but both deposits are still a drop in the bucket, considering the growing global demand for these critical minerals. It seems that for the foreseeable future, the world will remain dependent on China. The gap's glaring. Demand is exploding. EVs, renewables, and the West can't keep up. And that's where it gets ugly. China is limiting US access to rare earth minerals. The US is threatening deep sea mining. Tariffs are flying. Will we have a war? Maybe not in guns, but economic bloodshed is already here. Prices crash, supplies tighten, and experts voice major concerns for the US defense industry. Let me know where you think this is all headed. Subscribe for more stories about issues shaping our future. Thank you for watching.